Hi guys, today I'll be discussing and showing you an ancient underwater site, which I guarantee you have never heard of. This amazing Chinese site is called Shiyan Cave, which is probably the largest underwater stone quarry in the world. Besides its impressive machine marks, there are two fascinating facts about this site, which leads me to believe it was created by a prehistory civilization. Let's dive in. Shiyan Cave is said to be over 1,000 years old. It's located on Mount Xiqiao Park in the southern China, close to the South China Sea. Mount Xiqiao is no ordinary mountain. It's a 40 to 50 million year old extinct volcano situated between two major rivers on the Pearl River Delta. Stone tools found at Mount Xiqiao prove human activity in the region existed between 6,000 to 8,000 years ago. Covering an area of 14 square kilometers or 5.4 square miles, Mount Xiqiao has many springs and peaks, with the highest peak at 346 meters. Shiyan Cave is located on one of the peaks that is over 100 meters or 300 feet high. It's claimed to be an ancient quarry that was closed due to flooding. From afar, the entry to the cave is obscured by trees. When approaching the cave, you see a wide yet intricate opening in the form of a big horizontal crack. When you walk inside, you are amazed by the cave's carved-out spaciousness. The grand hall can likely hold 1,000 people, despite its small appearance from the outside. Walking further inside, you find a stream with boats. Here are three impressive man-made caverns submerged in water at a 100-meter high altitude. All of these, by the way, is inside an extinct volcano. Currently, the park offers boat tours into the submerged cave, which is about 200 meters or over 650 feet into the ancient quarry. But where did the water originate from and how deep is it? Nobody seems to know. It wasn't until 2009 when a group of cave divers first reported this underwater discovery. What the divers found shocked them. The cave is immense, with an estimated area of 60,000 square meters or 6.5 million square feet, which is 15 acres. Because the inner cave is submerged by water, it avoided natural weathering and man-made damage. The site is extremely well preserved with clear water. There are countless steps descending into the lower portion of the cave. Following the steps, the divers saw stone slabs put together which seems to be leftover products from long ago. These slabs look like the ones used as pavement in ancient China. This underwater cave is complicated with multiple sections and connecting passages. The divers also found oil lamp stands, bows, and bamboo ladders. Archaeologists used laser and sonar scanning to create a 3D model of Shiyan Cave. The bottom of the cave is covered by a thick layer of silt. Archaeologists inferred that there may be greater secrets still hidden and unrevealed. Mystery number one, tool marks. Looking at the footage and photos, I couldn't help but notice the familiar, large, and uniform tool marks on the almost straight cave walls. These markings are fairly identical to those found at Yangshan Quarry, Baalbek, Petra, and many other ancient sites. In a previous video, I explained why such marks couldn't be created by hand tools like chisels with this level of accuracy and consistency. Please click above to see that video. I think these marks resemble modern machine marks. Since the underwater cave was rediscovered not long ago and stayed untouched, we know these stone marks are not recent and must have been there for millennia. The cave was probably rediscovered 1,000 years ago and used as quarries. The Chinese masons likely never ventured into the deeper portions of this 15-acre cave because it would have been difficult to work there with oil lamps and to transport slabs. The thin stone slabs and rubble-piled steps show crude and inferior masonry methods, as opposed to the sophisticated, uniformed tool marks on the walls. We can tell that these two were not done by the same workers. This leads me to the theory that this cave is another megalithic structure created by a prehistory advanced civilization. So far, divers haven't reached the bottom of the cave. The deepest they have gone is 40 meters, which is about the height of a 13-story building. Shiyan Cave is on top of a hill, and the cave water is at an altitude of over 100 meters. The water table at the two nearby rivers is less than 3 meters above sea level, which means the cave water table is 100 meters higher than the original water table. Unbelievable. Mystery number 2. The puzzling water. Where did water originate? How come the water table in the cave is much higher than the nearby rivers? Is the cave possibly a part of a perched aquifer? A perched aquifer sits above the original water table with an unsaturated zone below. But perched aquifers are typically very small and are only replenished by local precipitation. The way Shiyan Cave was excavated, it gets no precipitation. However, the cave water table remains stable. Also, it contains too much water to be a perched aquifer. So where did the water come from? Remember that Mount Xiqiao has many springs. It turns out that some are artesian springs. In most cases, water flows downhill due to gravity. But artesian water flows to the land surface because the underground pressure forces the water upwards. An artesian aquifer has confined water, surrounded by layers of impermeable rock or clay which apply positive pressure to the water contained within the aquifer. If a well or a spring were to be sunk into an artesian aquifer, water in the well pipe would rise to a height corresponding to the point where hydrostatic equilibrium is reached, like the springs we see at Mount Xiqiao. This means there is at least one confined artesian aquifer inside an extinct volcano. If Shiyan Cave is connected to this aquifer, that could explain why the cave water is 100 meters higher than the original water table. The water here is well worth testing for analysis, which might reveal further clues of the cave's history. A local archaeologist believes that the flooding of the cave is a long-term process, maybe over hundreds of years, because they found neither human remains nor masonry tools in the cave. Whoever worked in the cave had prepared for the flooding by retreating to safer ground before water came in.
Then when did the water enter the cave? When was the cave first excavated? Was the cave created before the formation of the artesian aquifer? I say no. Would a major geological movement that formed the aquifer would have shattered the cave? If the aquifer was present during the excavation of the cave, does that mean the cave was flooded and the work was done underwater?
Not necessarily. Perhaps in prehistory times, the ancient workers accidentally broke the impermeable layer of the artesian aquifer, which caused the flooding. Maybe a few hundred years ago, the Chinese workers did so. Or maybe, just maybe, the cave was excavated when the aquifer was frozen. The last glacial period started about 110,000 years ago and lasted for 100,000 years. There were periods, such as the last glacial maximum, when Mount Xiqiao was potentially covered with ice and aquifers would have been frozen. If the cave was excavated during this freezing time period, then there will be no flooding issues. Nowadays, most artesian aquifers around the world are perpetually replenished by the ongoing flow of rain and groundwater. One can imagine that after the end of the last glacial period, the temperatures rose dramatically as the aquifers start to unfreeze. At the same time, the sea level went up, which could have pushed the groundwater level up. Also, the warming climate brought more rain. Together, the artesian aquifer inside Mount Xiqiao was replenished. Then the Shiyan Cave over time, due to warmer weather, became flooded. Mystery number 3, the purpose of the cave. From tool marks on the walls, we can see this process could have produced crushed stone instead of stone blocks or slabs. The modern machines that can create similar marks are used for mining. Today, crushed stone is a cheap product since stone is widely distributed all around the world, mostly used as construction material in concrete and asphalt. If crushed stone was the final product that the ancient workers were after, then why didn't they just use an open pit quarry, which would be easier and safer? What would have been the point of taking great trouble making a complex underground quarry for easily accessible crushed stone? It makes no sense. The site sits on top of a hill. Quarrying inside a cave on a hill means almost doubling the work. Hauling the crushed stone out of the deep cave and down a mountainside. That seems counterproductive. We can see the cave layout is unusual with multiple chambers and connecting pathways. The cave has different portions with different elevations. If the site was designed to be a quarry for mining stone, then why not keep it simple and flat? Why make the chambers at various depths? The different elevations would make it more difficult to transport stone out. The complicated layout has me thinking the cave was not originally excavated as a quarry. Possibly ancient workers were mining something more valuable than crushed stone. The irregular shapes of the cave could be the result of searching and mining for special minerals or precious metals. Mount Xiqiao is an extinct volcano. Volcanoes directly or indirectly produce or host deposit of many minerals and metals. It happens that not far from Shiyan Cave on Mount Xiqiao, a large good-grade silver deposit was found in a layer of brushier tuff. There is also a high grade of rare earth content here. A hill about 10 miles away from Mount Xiqiao has a large gold deposit and a separate, even larger high-grade silver deposit. The ores had already been assessed and the mining work has begun. The ores are said to be formed through multiple geothermal deposition and silicification, which means the Xiqiao volcano helped form the ores. Could Shiyan Cave actually be a prehistory mine? Based on the presence of large deposits of silver and gold nearby, it's very possible that Mount Xiqiao contained precious metal and minerals which were mined by a lost ancient civilization over 12,000 years ago during the last glacial period.
The well-preserved site at Shiyan Cave might provide invaluable evidence to study this lost civilization. Underwater archaeology experts and more in-depth research are still needed to further reveal this amazing mystery. If you have any insights, please leave me a comment. If you like my video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe. I have a wide range of topics that I want to share with you. This is Curious Being, I'm Tina. Thanks for watching and see you next time.